evening students, this is the third video for me. Now I will teach you about the respiratory system, circulatory system, nervous system, excretory system and repository system of leech. First I want to say about the respiratory system of leech. So here, what do you mean by respiration? It's a process of exchange of gases between the organism and the environment. And then here, this respiration, in the case of leech, respiration takes place through the skin alone. So this skin is having smaller or minute blood vessels. So these are also called as capillaries. So these capillaries are filled with the hemocelic fluid. And then, so exchange of gases takes place by the diffusion method. So here, the carbon dioxide diffuses, out while the oxygen, there is a dissolved oxygen, diffuses into the hemocelic fluid. And then, now I want to say about the circulatory system. So here, so circulation takes place through the hemocelic system here. So there is no blood vessels, two blood vessels here. So instead of blood vessels, they are having the hemocelic channels or they are having the hemocelic canals. And then, so this hemocelic channels or canals are filled with the blood-like fluid. So this blood-like fluid is having a blood pigment, it's also called as hemoglobin. And then there are four longitudinal channels are present. So one is present just above the adrenal canal. That is, one is present there at the dorsal surface of the adrenal canal. And then another one is present there at the ventral surface of the adrenal canal. It lies just below the adrenal canal. And then two lateral channels are present, one on either side of the adrenal canal. So here this lateral channels are also acting as a heart here. And then they are having the inner valves also. And then here, so all the four longitudinal channels are joined together at the 26th segment. So now I want to say about the nervous system of the leech. So that consists of a nerve ring and a paired ventral nerve cord. So this nerve ring surrounds the pharynx, and then which is formed of supra-pharyngeal ganglion, circumpharyngeal connective, and the third one is a sub-pharyngeal ganglion. So here the sub-pharyngeal ganglion lies below the pharynx, and which is formed by the fusion of four pairs of ganglia. And then, so this is the brain, and this one is the ventral nerve cord, and this is the ganglion. And then, I want to say about the excretory system of leech. Already you know about this. In the case of annelids, excretion takes place by the nucleus. So here, in the case of leech also, excretion takes place by the nucleus. So there are 17 pairs of nucleus are present, so which opens to the exterior through the pores. So these are also called as nucleus pores, and then these are present between the 6th and 22nd segments. And then here I want to say about the repository system of leech also. So first I want to say about the male repository system. There are 11 pairs of testes are present. So these testes are present between 12 to 22nd segments, and then these are each and every testes will be in a spherical shape. Because of that, these testes are also called as spherical sacs or testis sacs, and then which leads into the from each and every testes, so yes, short or small duct will be arise. So this short or small duct is also called as a vas deferens. So this vas deferens join along with the vas deferens, and then the vas deferens becomes converted to form the epididymis, so which is useful to store the sperm. And then so which leads to the ejaculatory duct, and then so ejaculatory duct of both the sides are joined together and formed as a genital atrium. So this genital atrium is having two regions. What are they? The first one is the prostate gland, and second one is the pineal sac. So here this pineal sac is having a penis, so which opens through the male genital pore. And then next I want to say about the female reproductive system. So here the consists of ovaries, oviducts, and vagina. So here there is a single pair of ovary will be present there in the 11th segment. And then here from each and every ovary, so a short small duct will be arise. So this short small duct is also called as a oviduct. And then the oviducts represent at the both the sides so joint together. And then they are also called as the common oviducts. And then this common oviduct can be opened into the pear-shaped vagina. So this vagina is present there in the 11th segment. So with this I want to finish.